So should I start?
हाँ जी स्टार्ट।
Good afternoon, everyone. As we are all here to celebrate National Education Day, I, Komal Sharma, on behalf of Co-Curricular Committee of Meyer College of Education, feel privileged to welcome you all in this online panel discussion on the pertinent topic in present educational scenario. New Education Policy 2020, a paradigm shift for higher education.
Disturbance क्यों आ रही है इतनी बीच में?
The National Education Day is celebrated every year on 11th November. The Government of India, Ministry of Human Resource Development, has declared this day as National Education Day to commemorate the birth anniversary of Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. An eminent educationist, great freedom fighter, and first education minister of India. On this day, India remembers the exemplary contributions of Maulana Azad in nation building, institution building, and particularly his indelible imprints in the field of education. As we know that education is at the threshold of change, many attempts have been made to bring innovation in it. The Ministry of HRD, Government of India, has formulated a new education policy 2020 for the country to meet the changing dynamics of population's requirement with regard to quality education, innovation and research, aiming to equip the students with necessary skills and knowledge. So in this connection, we are indeed lucky to have amidst us such educational luminaries who have by their presence made the occasion a very special one. Among the panelists, I extend a very warm welcome to our worthy principal and director, my group of institutions, Dr. Adit Gupta, who is a reservoir of knowledge. Dr. Gupta has a vast teaching and administrative experience of more than 24 years in the field of education, right from Model Academy School to doctoral level. Sir is a recipient of numerous national and international awards, receiver of research, reviewer of research papers in renowned journals, advisory and editorial board member of journals. Apart from this, he is a trained assessor of National Assessment and Accreditation Council. He has edited book chapters, handled research projects of UGC, participated and presented papers in national and international conferences and seminars, and numerous publications to his credit. I welcome you, sir.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
I extend a hearty welcome to respected Dr. N. R. Sharma, Dean Academics, Meyer College of Education. Professor Sharma is an eminent educationist and academician par excellence. He has been honored with prominent positions in the line of higher education, being HOD and Dean of Department of Education, University of Jammu and Central University of Jammu as well. Sir has extensive experience of over more than 40 years in the field of teacher education and research also. I welcome you, sir. I think Dr. Vikram Gulati has joined, sir.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you. There's a lot of internet issues and I've been trying.
Good afternoon, sir.
Hello, hello, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
It's a privilege.
Namaskar, Dr. Aditya.
Yes, sir. We were waiting for you.
Well, I tried my luck. This BSNL gave me a new modem and the other was not working. So some problem. It is not working. So I tried on my phone. Yeah. But thank you.
Oh.
हैंग हो गया रे।
कोमल मैम प्लीज अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ।
It's a privilege to have. Kindly switch off your mics. Kindly check your mics and switch them off. It's a privilege to have Dr. Vikram Gulati, Director and Principal Shivalik College of Education, Udhampur, as a panelist. Dr. Gulati also has an expansive and broad teaching and administrative experience of more than 28 years in the field of education, ranging from school to higher education level. He is an alumnus of Meyer College of Education, having enormous qualities of an effective teacher and an inspirational leader, which were quite evident when he was in school during his school days, as being at a responsible position of school pupil leader or an efficient captain of the school in 12th standard at Army Public School, Udhampur, where I was his junior and I probably remember his leadership qualities. Sir, if you remember me, I welcome you, sir. I also welcome Dr. Moolraj Sharma, HOD PG Department and Center for Educational Technology in Meyer College of Education. Dr. Sharma also has a wide experience of more than 20 years of professional experience in academics, administrative and research fields. He plays a prominent role in planning, development and utilization of educational technology in teacher training and other levels of education, including integration of technology with teaching learning process, evaluation, feedback, research, etc. Sir is the backbone of technology in our institution. I welcome you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
I now welcome our next panelist, Dr. Ronika Sharma, HOD UG department, and she heads both the B.Ed and the B.Ed special education course. Dr. Ronika has tremendous experience in the field of special education and teaching experience of more than 20 years in the field of education. Ma'am is an RCI registered professional. Apart from being associate professor in B.Ed special education, she has been working for IGNO as academic counselor for B.Ed special education, coordinator B.Ed special education MR, and also academic counselor for B.Ed special education MR, MP Bhoj University. She has also presented MP Bhoj Open University. She has also presented a number of papers at national and international levels. Apart from this, she's certified rehabilitation professional as an expert member of RCI and recently appointed as a member of Zonal Coordination Committee North Zone 2. I extend a very warm welcome to you, ma'am. I extend a warm welcome to our Deputy HODs of PG and UG Department, Dr. Nishtha Rana and Dr. Monica Bajaj, for their presence in this panel discussion. I also welcome all the faculty members and students who are a part of this panel discussion and who are there for this fruitful event, which is really going to help in their further endeavors. Sir, I request you now to kindly start with the discussion. Thank you.
Thank you, Komal ma'am, and welcome to all the panelists and participants in today's panel discussion. So the theme of the panel discussion is very apt, and being the National Education Day, it wouldn't have been, better to choose another topic because the National Education Policy, which has now come after a gap of over 33 years, is a really game-changing, policy for the field of education, which is both for school education as well as for higher education. Being in the College of Education, it is, a prerogative to discuss today the aspects of this policy which relate to higher education and specifically maybe in the field of teacher education. Before we start this discussion, and I request all my fellow panelists to put their points forth, so I'll request them that kindly take 5 to 10 minutes to put forth your valuable points. And after that, we will be having a group discussion where students would also be invited to participate and ask some questions. So starting, I'll just give you a small background of what the policy is. So there were many changes that were brought about in the previous policy on education, which came out last in the year 1986. And after that, you know, a lot of work has been done and education has emerged and changed at various levels. So it was prudent that we come up with a new policy that can cater to the current trends in education and also cater to the modern times in terms of both school and higher education. So this new policy brings a lot of flexibility. This policy, you know, brings removes distinctions between hard subjects and gives a lot of opportunity for the learners to be assessed on a continuous basis rather than just on the basis of an annual examination conducted at the end of the year. There is a lot of emphasis on conceptual development, creativity, and critical thinking that the students need to develop as important skills going forward. Apart from that, one of the biggest advantages of this technology, and since it has come at a time when we are all facing this pandemic and going through the COVID situation, is the use of technology. In fact, today's panel discussion could not have been possible if it was not for the use of technology itself. So how technology can be integrated into the field of education, into the, at the undergraduate level, at the postgraduate level, and in research. So there has been a big focus on technology in this new education policy. This educational policy also focuses on research. So there are numerous changes that have been brought about in encouraging faculty members and students to undertake research at the college and the university level, which again is a great focus that the competition we are facing globally in terms of research, that aspect is being rekindled by involving students and faculty members in research and providing a lot of funds for this. And last but not the least, the main aspect of this policy was to invite substantial investment into the education to make it more vibrant and to make it more, customer oriented, and also to ensure viability of educational institutions in the country. So there are a lot of points to go through, but I'll now request my worthy panelists. I'd like to start with our senior most colleague, Professor N.R. Sharma, to kindly throw some light on this new education policy 2020 and put forth his points for the benefit of the students and the participants. Professor Sharma.
Thank you very much. And all greetings to all panelists and students who are participating on National Education Day, which we celebrate in the country to celebrate the birth anniversary of a great educationist and the first education minister of independent India, Maulana Abul Kalam Azad, who had been instrumental for creating a number of universities and especially University Grants Commission and the Central Council of Industrial Research, which we call as the CSIR labs, and many more. Well, new education policy has finally come. Though teacher education is not very clear what will be the line of action, but it becomes clear when we say that the focus has to be on digital learning and online learning, as well as for development of critical thinking, so, and spirit of discovery. Now the question is that how we are going to achieve this. For this, the government has contemplated to go in for a 4-year undergraduate course instead of 3-year course. And Delhi University is already having a 4-year course for the last 3-4 years. But it will be entirely a different one with a different focus on different aspects. And why I'm talking about that under graduation, because that has implications for teacher education also. Now there, the traditional fixed type of monotonous streaming is, it has to be discontinued. Now it has to be open to different courses, which you call as the cafeteria approach. Now this cafeteria approach, in this approach, a student, a learner can select any subject. He can combine physics with music, with political science, with economics. He may not go in for the traditional physics, chemistry, mathematics, or botany, zoology, and then other chemistry and other subjects. No, it will be open. Now, my worry here is, what will be the fate of the teacher education in this context? What subjects we will be offering? And that is why perhaps the government has not come up very clearly at the moment, though it is too early. Because I know that committees are to be constituted and might have been constituted in the recent days. And all these things, taking into account the new education policies approach right up to graduation level, then and only then we can talk about that what will be the teacher education. But at the moment, we know that integrated BA, BEd, BSc, BEd, BCom, BEd, etc. These are to be introduced latest by 2030. But when we look into the, report that has been brought out, it says that 2-year traditional course will also continue. Even 1-year course may also continue. Now, only this much is written and nothing beyond it. But this is this new education policy is embarking on a Herculean task of raising the enrollment role, the GER, general enrollment role. Now, that is currently, I think it is around 26%, and it is to be raised to around 50%. It is not that easy. Even though the budget allocations will be raised to 6% from the current 4.43% of the GDP. I don't know whether this will be sufficient or not. Because when we are to open a new institutions, the financing is to be given. The colleges will be given autonomy, not only in conduct of examination, but even degree awarding also. And liberal assistance is being contemplated to be granted to these private institutions also, leaving aside the government institutions. Now, well, the onus will be on teachers, how to develop critical thinking, how to develop scientific temper, because in BEd colleges or in these our courses, which we have traditionally called as either going for specialization of teaching of science or teaching of mathematics or teaching of social studies. Now it will be entirely different, because a student at the undergraduate level who will be coming to us, he might be having physics, then music, then political science, and then art and craft also. So that will be the difficult task for the teacher education institutions, what is to be done. Well, that's why I say that the serious thinking is going on at the moment, that what should be the nature of teacher education and how to produce the would-be committed teachers. And there is the major problem. And for this purpose, admission will be through the NEET type admissions. National testing agency will be doing it on all India basis. And how the seats will be filled up, what will be the cutoff points, that is yet to be seen. So at the moment, this is, and this more will be coming up. Right. And during the course of discussions, But ultimate focus is on development of human values, right, and honesty. And what we say that to be a democratic and to be just and socially conscious and cultured and human nation citizens holding liberty and equality and whatnot.
Right, sir.
It will all depend upon the teachers and the curriculum that we will be having.
Right.
At the moment, I can say in the initial stages that what we are going to have about the higher education as well as the teacher education.
Right.
Thank you
so much. So I'll request Dr. Vikram Gulati to bring up some of his ideas about the national education policy.
Dr. Gulati,
you can probably add some points now.
A big pranam to Professor N.R. Sharma, my mentor.
God bless you.
Such beautiful days in the university under your headship. And of course, what an honor to be again with Dr. Adit back to my alma mater, Meyer College, from where I had my first lessons in teacher education. Professor Sharma, Dr. Adit, Dr. Moolraj, Madam, our specialist from the behavioral sciences, what's her name, ma'am? Doctor?
Ronika,
yes. All the honors that you keep getting, heartiest congratulations to you and Meyer, yes. पहले तो मैं डॉक्टर आदित्य मैं ये देख रहा था कि इफ यू रिकॉल हमारे डॉक्यूमेंट में ये एक चीज इन्होंने कहा हमारी मिनिस्ट्री ने दैट वी वांट टू कंप्लीटली ओवरहॉल वी वांट टू रीएनर्जाइज द हायर एजुकेशन सिस्टम सो फर्स्ट थॉट दैट केम टू माय माइंड कि क्या इतना बुरा था हमारा हायर एजुकेशन सिस्टम दैट वी नीड टू एकदम ओवरहॉल इट लाइक I'm a product of this higher education system. So was I not good enough for the society? Did I not contribute? What is it that they want to bring in? You know, aisa kya magic karna chahte hain government? Ye toh time will tell. But of course, there are certain challenges which we see in our current system. You know, for example, as a teacher, because there are students also who are on this webinar, this panel discussion. Students, you know what? Teachers always want more autonomy. Institutions also want more autonomy. And our constitution grants us this autonomy. Main aapse ek baat kahunga ki B.Ed ki teaching mein kai varsh tak hum log ek bahut beautiful si cheez kar rahe the, skill training through micro teaching. Developing skilled teachers. Suddenly, Professor N.R. Sharma will agree with me. कहीं दिल्ली में teacher educators की कोई सरकार बदली मतलब teacher educators की lobby change हुई और उन्होंने national curriculum framework एक नया dress पहनाकर बोला जी ये लीजिए इस तरह से training करिए. So they gave colleges of education a new bottle. But only with lot of restrictions. ये करना है third semester में ये fourth semester में करना है इसको आप बदल नहीं सकते ऐसा नहीं कर सकते. So we were working in a very constrained, rigid environment which did not give us autonomy. मैं National Education Policy 2020 को इसलिए पसंद करूँगा कि ये मुझे autonomy देगी ये मुझे फ्रीडम देगी जो ये क्लेम करती है कि मुझे देगी यानी मैं चाहता हूं कि मैं अपने कॉलेज में जम्मू यूनिवर्सिटी लेट इट बी द एग्जामिनिंग बॉडी करिकुलम को लेकर मैं फ्रीडम चाहूंगा मैं चाहूंगा ऐसा ना हो एनईपी 2020 में फिर से एक सेंट्रलाइज्ड करिकुलम हो मैं क्यों नहीं चाहूंगा मायर कॉलेज की तरह एक ऑटोनॉमस एबिलिटी एक डिसीजन मेकिंग हो करिकुलम में फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी हो पेडागोजी कैसी होगी असेसमेंट कैसी होगी और स्टूडेंट्स को किस तरह के एक्सपीरियंसेस दिए जाएंगे ये फ्रीडम ये ऑटोनॉमी अब इस समय एक चैलेंज है मुझे मालूम नहीं, मुझे लगता नहीं माहिर के लिए चैलेंज होगा, बिकॉज आप ऑलरेडी ऑटोनोमस कॉलेज है, बधाई है आपको, और शायद अगले 10 साल के लिए भी आपको यूजीसी ने ये ऑनर दिया है. बट देखिए जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं इस समय पैनल पे, स्टूडेंट्स मैं आपको एक बात बताना चाहूंगा जो बड़ी मेरे को तब भी खटक रही थी. अब इन्होंने क्या किया है, यू नो दे हैव सेड कि जो अभी एक जो एग्जाम होता है जिसको हम टीईटी बोलते हैं, टीचर एलिजिबिलिटी टेस्ट, टीचर एलिजिबिलिटी टेस्ट जो है वो अभी टू कंपोनेंट्स में होता है, पार्ट वन एंड पार्ट टू. बिकॉज हमारा जो स्कूल एजुकेशन स्ट्रक्चर है वो पार्ट वन पार्ट टू से चलता है. तो अब इन्होंने न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी में जो चेंजेस इन्होंने स्कूल एजुकेशन में लाए हैं वो डेफिनेटली टीचर एजुकेशन में हमें इफेक्ट करेंगे. ये मेरी एक ऑब्जर्वेशन है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल नाउ दे हैव डिवाइडेड द स्कूल स्ट्रक्चर इनटू फोर पार्ट्स. वी ऑल नो फोर पार्ट्स में स्कूल एजुकेशन स्ट्रक्चर इन्होंने कर दिया है. और उसके लिए जैसे उसका मतलब होगा कि सम पीपल वुड बी गिविंग टीईटी फाउंडेशनल, सम वुड बी गिविंग टीईटी प्रेपरेटरी, somebody would be giving TET middle secondary. Okay, इसका मतलब आपके चार तरह के TET होंगे और उसके लिए वो subject teachers they would have to, किस तरह से वो कौन सा TET देंगे, और जिस national testing authority की agency की बात की जा रही है तो वो किस तरह से उसके scores होंगे और उसको वो कैसे uniform level पे लाएंगे. एंड और एक मैं और इसमें चीज देख रहा था कि दैट सम प्रोफेसर वाज आल्सो सेइंग दैट नाउ फ्रॉम 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 दिस एजुकेशन पॉलिसी इट विल बी वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट इन बीएड कॉलेजेस स्टूडेंट्स वुड हैव टू, देयर वुड बी नो चॉइस, दे वुड हैव टू डेवलप लर्न इंटरव्यू स्किल्स. तो मैं चाहूंगा कि मायर कॉलेज इसमें लीड ले और इंटरव्यू स्किल्स जो है वो डेवलप करना शुरू कर दें, बिकॉज इंटरव्यू इज अ वेरी वेरी स्पेशल स्किल. अभी मैंने 4 दिन पहले 3-4 लड़कियों का पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट्स का वो लिया और मैं आपको बताऊं, मैंने आई गेव देम 15 मिनट्स टू राइट एन एसे एंड 20 मिनट्स टू टॉक अबाउट दैट एसे. मैडम रिटन वाला तो छोड़ दो, उसमें प्रोफेसर एन आर शर्मा वुड नो कि हमारे पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट्स राइटिंग स्किल्स नहीं डेवलप हो पाए हैं अभी भी, लेकिन दी डिस्कशन स्किल्स वर इक्वली बैड. तो जो बच्चे इस समय मायर कॉलेज के इस पैनल में हैं, बच्चों एक बात स्टूडेंट्स में बोलूंगा आपको कि एक चीज बात याद रखो, यू विल हैव टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट वेरी गुड क्वालिटी ऑफ इंटरव्यू स्किल्स. एंड मैं अपने कॉलेज में मॉक एक वो करवाता हूँ, रेज्यूमे राइटिंग करवाता हूँ बच्चों की, और मॉक इंटरव्यूज, अभी कोविड आ गया तो इस साल तो हुए नहीं, तो मॉक इंटरव्यू जो है उसकी तैयारी करना. सो दैट मीन्स स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बीएड विल हैव टू लर्न, दे विल हैव टू लर्न बेटर, दे विल हैव टू बिकम बेटर इन देयर स्पीच स्किल्स, कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स, एबिलिटी टू एक्सप्रेस देमसेल्फ, एबिलिटी टू रीजन, डिस्कस, और जो डॉक्टर आदित्य बोल रहे थे आपके प्रिंसिपल साहब, क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग. It will be very, very important B.Ed colleges के लिए कि ये 21st century skills जिसको हम लोग कहते हैं the 5 C's or the 7 C's, communication, collaboration, creativity, critical thinking, इसके ऊपर colleges को अपना curriculum और अपने ऐसा courses जो हैं वो किया जाए. अच्छा अभी मैं एक मिनट में एक बात और इसमें कहना चाहूंगा कि ये जैसे कि फॉर एग्जाम्पल ये कहते हैं कि ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, ये मैंने अपना पीपीटी में यहाँ पे एक पॉइंट लिखा था, अभी मैं फोन से कर रहा हूँ ना जी तो वो मेरा चल नहीं रहा नेट. सो वी हैव लॉट ऑफ डेटा ऑन, मेरी फिफ्थ स्लाइड कहाँ गई, वंस अगेन. Okay, yeah. So Dr. Adit was also saying one very important thing that I want you to talk about was the credit bank. ये बहुत अच्छी चीज होने जा रही है. स्टूडेंट्स ये आप इस तरह से समझ के चलिए कि जैसे आपको मालूम है कि यू वुड बी एबल टू डू योर डिग्री इधर इन 3 years और 4 years विद रिसर्च. सो यू हैव 1 year yes, 1 year where you can, you know, you could do some research. So you are an honors with 4 years. So ये जो academic bank of credit है ये बहुत काम आएगा. और ये भी हमें देखना होगा कि हम इस academic bank of credit को कैसे teacher education में इसको carry forward करें और teacher education के credit bank को हम कैसे क्या नाम था इसका रखा है उन्होंने शायद academic bank of credit. Academic credit bank से. तो प्रोफेसर एना शर्मा साहब मैं ये देखना चाहता था जो मुझे ये थोड़ा सा समझ में था कि कुछ लोग जो टीचर्स बनेंगे इंटीग्रेटेड से कुछ लोग बनेंगे जो 3 year ग्रेजुएट के बाद बनेंगे कुछ में कहा गया है कि पीजी करके 1 साल में वो बन जाएंगे तो वो भी मेरे को थोड़ा उसमें क्लैरिटी चाहिए होगी कि क्या उनकी कॉम्पिटेंसीज जो 4 साल करके बीएड कर रहा है नेचुरली उसका करिकुलम जो है वो ज्यादा इनडेप्थ रहा होगा वो उन सोशल साइंसेज में और वॉली स्टडीज में बिहेवियरल साइंसेज उसने ज्यादा पढ़ी होगी विज़ाविज जो केमिस्ट्री के साथ हमारे पास आएगा और तो वो भी एक कि किस तरह से इंटीग्रेटेड 4 years या 1 year मास्टर प्रोग्राम या 2 years आफ्टर ग्रेजुएशन तो उसमें वो कैसे वो इक्विवेलेंस और वो बैलेंस कैसे लाना चाहेंगे. और इस एनईपी में एक बहुत अच्छी बात है कि गवर्नमेंट ने कहा है कि मॉडल मल्टी डिसिप्लिनरी एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूशंस एंड यूनिवर्सिटीज दे वुड बी अलाउड टू सेट अप कैंपसेस आउटसाइड. तो प्रोफेसर एनआर शर्मा जैसे जिन्होंने जिंदगी दी है टीचर एजुकेशन को तो मुझे लगता है कि ये शायद आपको भी ये ऑटोनॉमी मिलनी चाहिए कि भाई आप लोग कैंपसेस अपने सेटअप करें एक्सपैंड करें और कोलैबोरेट करके और बाहर से भी कह दें कि फॉरेन इंस्टीट्यूशंस वुड कम इन एंड देयर वुड बी कोलैबोरेशन. तो 1 साल बच्चे मायर में पढ़े मायर उनको एक प्लेटफॉर्म दे यहाँ से वो ऑस्ट्रेलिया में 4 credit लें 4 credit वहां से लेकर वापस इंडिया में आए. आई थिंक ये सारी बात इसलिए हो रही है बिकॉज इंडिया वॉन्ट्स टू टेल द वर्ल्ड दैट वी आर नॉट ओनली अ लार्ज एग्रीकल्चरल कंट्री बट वी आर ऑल्सो द वर्ल्ड्स लार्जेस्ट ह्यूमन रिसोर्स इंजीनियरिंग नेशन. सो ये सारी ह्यूमन रिसोर्स इंजीनियरिंग की बात हो रही है और एज द डिस्कशन progresses I would come back. Thank you so much
for your valuable thoughts and I'll request Dr. Moolraj to now be part of this discussion and initiate his thoughts with the participants.
Yeah, thank you Mr. So respected panelists and teachers and students. So first of all, I'll congratulate our college as well as the team who worked directly or indirectly for selecting the topic. And the topic clearly says that it is a paradigm shift for higher education. So basically, what is a paradigm shift is very important because since 1986, there was no policy and the guidelines for the coming, you can say, future aspects or even the present scenario. But that took us, you can say, for a new influences or new guidelines, and that will be with the time will be taken over by the from the NPE, that's a national policy in 1986. So this was a good topic, and I think national education policy or whatever it is that is new education policy 2020. So this. Policy has given many directions, and I think I'll focus on some tasks that has been assigned to we people now as a teacher, as a student, or the coming teacher trainees, right? So those are the basic tasks for us to complete either as a stakeholder or as a body, right? So First of all, if we think that they have given the main aim, and the main aim is that our country should be a global knowledge superpower. So that is a very high, I think, goal which has been set for us. They have told that since in 2018, the gross enrollment ratio was 26.3, and it has been aspired that it should go up to 50% by 2035. So that is again a task for all of us. And you can say next parameter can be a quality, that they are asking that quality will be ensured through, whether it is through multidisciplinary universities, whether it is through higher education institution clusters, whether it is a research university, whether it is academic or teaching intensive university, or whether it be autonomous degree granting colleges. So these are the infrastructural development which they want. And they have made a balance between the, you can say, traditional Indian aspects and the foreign hired, you can say, knowledge or processes. So on the one side, they talk about that we have to take into consideration the ancient, you can say, values of which were imparted through Nalanda or Vikramshila, etc., right? And on the other hand, they are talking about that it can be a global citizenship education. So which Dr. Sharma also talked about, that we have to see the values, various values, whether it is Satya, Dharma, Shanti, Prem, etc., right? And on other side, they are talking about various, you can say, multidisciplinary aspects of the education. And in these development, they have also focused on the technology, that is the other side, that technological developments are, you can say, very much now required, and it is the need of the hour, as COVID have taught us. So they have made another development, right? And that will be whether it is National Educational Technology Forum, right? Or even creating digital infrastructure, or even digital content, or side-by-side capacity building, right? So they have set this also in front of us. And one more aspect which they took in the traditional is that Vishwa Guru. So if India has to act a source of Vishwa Guru, then they have to take care of all these things. And if I talked about in, I can say, last point, and that too is that the structure of master degrees and bachelor degrees. So that is again, as Dr. Gulati has also focused on that. So these are going to be challenges for us as well. And I think we all have to work for this, even as a single entity or a single human being, and as a institution also. So I think these were the basic points which are there in the policy. And I think these are very, you can say, pertinent as well as fascinating us at present. But let us see how much we can do justice to these points. So thank you very much.
Thank you so much for sharing your thoughts with us. I'll request Dr. Ronika Sharma to kindly share her points of views about the National Education Policy 2020.
Sure, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Well, I would like to highlight equity and inclusion in higher education, because we all are moving from segregation to inclusion. But what are the steps which we are need to take as a higher education institute? I would like to highlight all those steps rather. There is a dire need to mitigate opportunity, costs, and fees for pursuing higher education. We need to provide more financial assistance and scholarships to socially, economically disadvantaged society. Not only this, if we want higher education to be inclusive, we need to make admission process more inclusive first. We need to have curriculum more inclusive. There is a dire need to increase employability and then potential for higher education programs, of course. Although in India, we are running degree courses, which are only in Indian languages. So we need to develop more degree courses taught in Indian languages and bilingually. There is a dire need to ensure all buildings and facilities are wheelchair accessible and disabled friendly. Because when we say education for all, we need to be well prepared for that. I think we need to develop bridge courses for students that come from disadvantaged educational backgrounds. And of course, we need to provide socio-emotional and academic support and mentoring for all such students through suitable counseling and mentoring programs, because there was a time when disability is a stigma. So there is a dire need to have socio-emotional and academic support for all these students. And yes, this is possible only through the sensitization of faculty, counselor, and students on gender identity issue and its inclusion in all aspects of higher education institutions, including your curriculum aspects. I would like to highlight that we need to strictly enforce all no discrimination and anti-harassment rules. And yes, we need to develop institutional development plans. So if we really want inclusion in real sense, we need to take care of all these steps to make inclusion, you know, to be implemented in letter and spirit. So I think there is a need to think, to ponder upon inclusion and equity. There was a time when we were talking for equality, but now we are moving from equality to equity. So we need to talk and we need to think for equity for the better inclusion and to have an inclusive society. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Romika. I would just take 5 minutes to, you know, give a small summary to all the students about what are the features of this national education policy, so that everybody knows what we are in for. So the government has said that the biggest challenge for us is to getting more students into colleges and universities. And as Professor Anna Sharma said, and Dr. Moolraj also said, that we need to improve the gross enrollment ratio. So that is a big plan. So for that, the government is saying that we are going to have a higher education institution of the country. And the aim is to have at least 3,000 students in every district. Then they want that no college will be established in the country, which will be an affiliated college of the university, and all colleges will be established as autonomous colleges, so that all colleges will get autonomy to prepare their own curriculum, have their own examination, and have their own system of admissions in the country. And for all the colleges that are existing now, they will be providing a graded autonomy to all the colleges. So this process will take the next 15 years. So in the next 15 years, all colleges will have to come up to a benchmark, will have to come to a standard, so that they can be accredited or recognized as an autonomous college institution. Apart from that, institutions will also be allowed to run open distance learning programs, provided they are accredited for it. So that means all have a chance to provide even distance learning programs for our students who from far-flung areas are unable to attend colleges. Then they have focused that from now on, no educational institution will be a single stream educational institution. So that means all colleges of education in the country and all other higher education institutions will have to convert to a multidisciplinary institution. उन्होंने कहा है कि 4-year degree program होगा, यानी कि सिंगल स्ट्रीम, हमारे कॉलेज में अभी बी एड चल रहा है, तो बी एड इज अ सिंगल स्ट्रीम प्रोग्राम एंड इज अ 2-year प्रोग्राम. 20-30 इंस्टीट्यूशंस कैन रन दिस 2-year प्रोग्राम, बट बिफोर दैट एवरीबडी हैज टू शिफ्ट टू अ मल्टी डिसिप्लिनरी प्रोग्राम. तो इसके बाद बी एड जो होगा वो सिर्फ 4 ईयर टीचर एजुकेशन प्रोग्राम होगा जो कि ग्रेजुएशन बीएड बीएससी बीएड और इस तरह के प्रोग्राम होंगे, इसी बेसिस पे किया जाएगा. एंड one of the biggest you know advantages is that a very easy entry and exit system. If by chance abhi kya hota hai ki bachcha koi jo 3 saal ka graduation join karta hai and he drops out, so those years that he has put in the college are wasted, but now that won't happen. So if after 1 year the college the student drops out of the college, he will get a certificate. If after 2 years he'll drop out, he'll get a diploma. If after 3 years he'll drop out, he'll get a degree. And after 4 years, if he drops out or completes the 4-year program, then he'll get a degree with research or an honors degree. So that means entry and exit barriers have been removed in the new educational policy. Then the whole choice-based credit system is being revitalized and changed. As Dr. Gulati rightly said, that academic bank of credit is being created, which means that, for example, after 2 years, you will have, if you plan to drop out of college, so whatever credits that you have accumulated in the first 2 years, wo aapke bank mein chale jayenge, jo usko hum credit bank bolte hain. Aur suppose 3 saal baad aap kehte ho, main apni graduation complete karna chahta hoon ya apne higher education ko pursue karna chahta hoon, to aapne jo shuru mein credits accumulate ki hain, they will not be wasted. They are in your bank. So you can use those credits to add to the future credits that you will accrue, and you can always get a degree. So this is another big modification in this policy. Then from high stakes examination, we are moving towards more continuous and comprehensive evaluation. So it will not be just at the end of the year that this program will happen. Then we are taking our education at an international level. We are asking international universities, the top 100 international universities, to open campuses in India so that we can bring all those global trends and modern educational requirements at the Indian doorsteps. We are also asking our Indian universities and colleges, which are top ranked, to open foreign campuses so that there is equal opportunity for both Indian as well as foreign students to come and learn in each other's environment, which is, and in fact, when this happens, then it is going to be serious competition for our colleges and universities, because if we don't get our quality and quality of education up to international standards, then you can answer this question yourself. Why would a student like to study in a substandard college or a university when he can get world-class education in a foreign university in India without traveling abroad and without spending so much of money? So these are big challenges for our universities and colleges also. Then our big focus is on vocational education. So vocational education is being targeted both in the school level as well as at the university and the college level. So vocational programs will have to be offered. Besides that, there is going to be a national research foundation that is going to be set up, which is going to provide money to teachers and to students to conduct research in their area, and also to grant funds for proposals and research projects in different areas. So India is looking forward to become a research superpower also. Then bodies like the UGC, like the AICT, these bodies are being amalgamated as part of the Higher Education Commission of India, which is HECI, which is going to be the topmost body in the country that is going to regulate higher education. But bodies like NCTE, bodies like NAC, they will continue to exist because these would be the standard setting bodies. NAC is NAAC, National Assessment and Accreditation Council. So now it is being converted only to NAC. That means National Accreditation Council. So they'll only be doing the accreditation part of colleges. So apart from that, we are, evolving institutions as either professional or either general education to a multidisciplinary education system. So a lot of meaningful changes, are being brought in the country because of this policy, and these changes are going to benefit us, all the teachers and the students, in a big way. So this was just a summary of what this policy was all about. We can have Komal ma'am, some students who are there, if they are ready to ask some questions. Otherwise, I'll request the panelists only if they have any other point or any other, these important suggestions to make. This would be now the right time to do that.
Right. Thank you, sir. Now I request our students and faculty members also to kindly ask any question if they have to the expert panel. Students, you can just switch on your mics and ask it. The UG and PG students.
Yes.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Good afternoon, sir.
Yes, Neha.
Sir, as a new education policy, it will make boon or it will make as a cause for the society or for the students.
Right. So I can ask Professor Sharma to kindly respond whether the new education policy is going to be a boon or a curse for the students. Professor Sharma is connected.
Mic unmute, sir.
Sharma sir, kindly switch on your mic. Aapka mic, sir.
So I can ask Dr. Gulati to initiate this discussion till Sharma joins us.
So Sharma sir's mic is on also.
हाँ जी.
Yes, yes.
मेरा कहना ये है कि ये न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी कोई जादू की छड़ी नहीं है, मैजिक बैंड नहीं है.
Right.
और जिस तरह से हम ये एनविसेज कर रहे हैं, अगर ये 2021 से शुरू होती है
जी,
और जो पहली क्रॉप निकलेगी इट विल बी आफ्टर अराउंड 2021 इयर्स.
राइट.
इन बिटवीन वो होंगे जो ऑलरेडी चल रहे हैं, उसी वैल्यू सिस्टम से चल रहे हैं.
राइट.
और मेरा सिर्फ ये है कि अगर ये हो जाता है, क्या अदर पैरामीटर्स ऑफ सोसाइटी विल चेंज?
राइट.
जो हमारे सिचुएशन है, मुझे नहीं कहना चाहिए, बट वी आर फोर्स एज टीचर्स, वी आर फोर्स बिकॉज वी आर ऑल विक्टिम ऑफ द सेम सिचुएशन. जो पॉलिटिकल इंटरफेरेंस है, विल इट स्टॉप? इंटरव्यूज में जो इंटरफेरेंस होती है वो रुक जाएगी? ये तो न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी में कहीं नहीं लिखा है. ये एक आइडियल चीज है कि ऐसा होगा तो इधर भी होगा, होगा नहीं होगा दैट इज अ डिफरेंट थिंग. इसीलिए ये जो बच्ची ने पूछा है कि इट विल बी अ बून और कर्स, मेरे ख्याल मैं दूसरा वर्ड सुन नहीं सका था. वेल होपफुली हम टीचर्स हमेशा ऑप्टिमिस्ट होते हैं, होपफुल फॉर द बेटर फ्यूचर ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स. लगता तो है कि ठीक होगा, बट इट विल ओनली द टाइम विल टेल.
Right, sir.
पहले भी बनी है और पॉलिसीज पहले 68 में आई है, 86 में आई है, मॉडिफाइड 92 में हुई है. पॉलिसीज में नहीं कुछ गड़बड़ होती है.
राइट.
गड़बड़ होती है उसकी इम्प्लीमेंटेशन में.
राइट.
और हमारी जो सोसाइटी है ये वेस्ट की सोसाइटी की तरह ओपन नहीं है. इट इज ए क्लोज सोसाइटी, ए कंजर्वेटिव सोसाइटी. And the typical characteristic of a closed society or the conservative society is the change with reluctance.
Right.
Oh, immediately change नहीं होती. अभी आप देखेंगे जब ये हो जाएगा, बड़ा human cry होगा. जो teachers already हैं, जो students हैं, वो कहेंगे ये क्या आ गया है, ये होगा. लेकिन मेरा जैसे कहा था कि 2022 years लगेंगे जब नई crop of students with a new value system जो हम envisage कर रहे हैं new education policy में, then that will come. इसलिए don't be demoralized. Students को मैं कह रहा हूँ, don't be demoralized. It will be a boon to you, hopefully, and it has to be.
Right. Thank you.
I think her question is answered now.
Right. So I think so.
Or more confusion.
Come in and say a few words as well.
Professor Sharma Saab, the document of the new education policy, you know, it clearly says that teacher will be the center of the fundamental reforms in our education system. और ये कहा जा रहा है कि ये पहली policy है which will re-establish teachers at all level. That means teachers will now be, you know, given a seat in metro train. Like I was traveling and there was an old man, there was a young man, there was a lady and myself. So there was one seat. So now we had to decide ki aurat baithegi ki buda baithega. Aur jo is student ne sawal pucha na beta, bada relevant sawal hai. Na buda baith paya na aurat. मैं तो टीचर था, मैं तो कभी नहीं बैठ पाऊंगा क्योंकि मैं तो खड़े होकर पढ़ाता हूं. वो जवान आदमी ने ऑक्यूपाई कर ली वो सीट. यू नो, सो आई हैड टू टेल हिम, आई सेड लुक यार, ये मेरे हाथ की पांच उंगलियां हैं, विच वन वुड यू लाइक टू यू नो टेक. कहता जी समझ नहीं आया. मैंने कहा चूज एनी फिंगर बिकॉज यू हैव चूजन कन्वीनियंस. तेरे को कन्वीनियंस थी, यू फॉरगॉट टू सी द ओल्ड मैन स्टैंडिंग नेक्स्ट टू यू. यू डिड नॉट इवन बॉर्डर टू आस्क द लेडी की मैडम आप बैठोगे. और मैंने कहा मैं रहा टीचर, मुझे तो ना कोई पूछेगा ही ना कोई. सो द ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर, ये उन्होंने 15 अगस्त के फ्रॉम द रैम्पार्ट्स ऑफ रेड फोर्ट कहा था कि इस देश में टीचर्स को वो स्थान मिलेगा जो भारत में था. इन अदर वर्ड्स, टीचर्स are expected to be the most respected, essential, the finest members of the society. You and I, the change has to start from you and I. We cannot call this policy a curse because the focus of this policy is on re-empowerment, re-energizing, giving that place back to the teachers, you know, which we always had. So I would congratulate the government of India, you know, for it. He's giving this to a thought कि ये policy तभी आएगी. 2040 में प्रोफेसर शर्मा ने कहा है और ये document में भी कहीं पर लिखा हुआ है कि by 2040 we should see a different India. 20 साल मुझे लगा इन्होंने ज्यादा दे दिए. आज technology के रास्ते अगर चलना हो तो we have seen in COVID-19 lockdown in less than 9 months. Everybody has learned how to use educational tools. Everybody has learned, you know, small children, whether they are in class one or they are in university. What will you say about those lazy bums? Wo abhi bhi kehte hain, sir, ye nahi hai, wo nahi hai, ye kya ho raha hai, bakwas hai, ye online ekdam bekar hai, ye hai, wo hai. So new education policy is aimed. Yehi change wo lana chahti hai, new education policy. Readiness, willingness, volunteerism to make our place in the society. India has to compete with, you know, a small country like Finland. It commands so much of respect. Dr. Aditya would tell you sometime ki ek itni ye jo Nokia phone hai wo Finland ne isko invent kiya tha. और पूरी दुनिया आज उस टेक्नोलॉजी को यूज कर रही है. सो स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ दिस कंट्री, यू आर द फ्यूचर ऑफ टुमारो. देयर इज लॉट, दिस न्यू पॉलिसी इज अ गोल्ड माइन प्रोवाइडेड यू लव माइनिंग. थैंक यू.
सो देयर वाज वन क्वेश्चन अबाउट वेदर दिस न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी इन द स्कूल सिस्टम दे हैव क्रिएटेड अ स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ 5-3-3-4 व्हिच वाज अर्लियर द 10+2 पैटर्न. So whether this is going to bring any kind of change or not. Dr. Moolraj or Dr. Ronika, if you would like to take up this question.
Yes, sir. Though we are focusing at present on higher education, but though it is the base of higher education, yes, maybe if we see back the points made by Dr. Gulati, that if we think about the foundation courses preparation or the secondary level, so yes, there will be a little difference because we are focusing on the teacher first, because we are preparing now teachers, or we will be preparing teachers who will be specific to that particular child psychology or the area which they are, you can say, belong to. So I think, yes, it can be useful in my opinion. Yeah.
And also I would like to say that 5+3+3+4, it's a new name for 10+2 basically. So iska matlab hai kya? 5 ka matlab hua, you know, pre-nursery, junior, प्री नर्सरी, नर्सरी एंड जूनियर. सो 3 years उसके, और फर्स्ट और सेकंड, सो ये बनते हैं 5 साल, राइट। उसके बाद बनता है थर्ड फोर्थ फिफ्थ, उसके बनते हैं 3 साल, फिर बनता है 6th 7th 8th, उसके बनते हैं 3 साल, और 9th से लेके 12th उसके बनते हैं 4 साल। सो इफेक्टिवली है वही पैटर्न, बट सिर्फ उसको उन्होंने डिवाइड कर दिया है डिफरेंट एज ग्रुप्स में, और ये कह दिया है कि फोकस जो होगा वो अपनी ट्रेडिशनल मदर टंग पे और लैंग्वेज लर्निंग पे, और जो बाकी फीचर स्कूल एजुकेशन पॉलिसी के हैं वो फिफ्थ, पहले 5 साल में क्या होंगे, फिर 3 साल में क्या होंगे, और इन इन सालों में बच्चों को क्या क्या स्किल्स आनी चाहिए और क्या उनको सीखना चाहिए। सो दैट इज द ओनली चेंज, अदरवाइज देर इज नो चेंज इन, देर इज नो बडी विल हैव टू स्टडी मोर क्लासेस और लेस क्लासेस, क्लासेस वुड बी द सेम।
एक्चुअली डॉक्टर साहब इसमें एक और चीज है, इन्होंने इसको फॉर्मलाइज कर दिया है। जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल सरकारी स्कूल में जो प्रेवलेंट सिस्टम था पूरे इंडिया में, ज्यादातर 6 साल की उम्र में क्लास 1 से, मतलब ये गिनती क्लास 1 से करते थे कि भैया इनका रिकॉर्ड स्कूल का जो भी यूडाइज सिस्टम था वो क्लास 1 से शुरू होता था। सो एनरोलमेंट जो है भारत सरकार क्लास 1 से मानती थी, अब NEP 2020 में वो कहा है कि एनरोलमेंट हम मानेंगे एट द एज ऑफ 3, यानी समबडी हु इज इन एज ऑफ 3 ईयर्स उसका पूरा डेटा गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया के पास होगा, और गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ने इसको इंपॉर्टेंस दी है, चाहे शायद दे प्लान टू डू इट थ्रू आंगनवाड़ी बालवाड़ी, मायर भी चलाता था ये सेंटर, आप चलाते थे इसको पहले, बालवाटिका बोलते हैं शायद, और जिसको आपने ठीक कहा द प्री स्कूल अम्ब्रेला, सब लोग सब उसमें आ गए। बट इसमें इसमें बहुत गवर्नमेंट ने इसको शायद एक्सेप्ट कर लिया है कि इट इज वेरी फॉर्मेटिव एज, और प्रोफेसर रोनिका यू आर अ साइकोलॉजिस्ट, इस पे आप जरूर बच्चों को बताएं कि ये फॉर्मेटिव इयर्स की, कहते हैं कि फॉर्मेटिव इयर्स के एक्सपीरियंसेस डिटरमिन करेंगे कि आप लाइफ में कितना अच्छा चल पाएंगे।
सर आई वुड लाइक टू ऐड ऑन हियर दैट व्हेन वी टॉक फॉर फॉर्मेटिव इयर्स, तो अर्ली इंटरवेंशन इज मस्ट, तो यू कैन ओनली अर्ली इंटरवीन इफ यू हैव स्टूडेंट्स विद यू,
right?
So foundational education system is very much required, and of course wo kaha jata hai na ki aapki neev kaisi hai usi ke upar aapki puri building adharit hai, to base jo hai usko strong karna is only possible when you give an opportunity to the student to come to the purview of this foundational education,
right?
Actually Dr. Ronika and Dr. Gulati,
sir
I have one point to make here, कि जो फर्स्ट 3 ईयर्स हैं प्री प्राइमरी के, जो फर्स्ट 3 ईयर्स हैं उसमें ओनली प्ले वे है, फॉर्मल एजुकेशन नहीं है।
इट्स ऑल काइंड ऑफ यू आर गिविंग अ चांस टू द चाइल्ड टू अर्ली यू नो हैविंग अ स्टार्टअप, यू कैन से इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ थिंग व्हेन यू से यू आर डेवलपिंग द फाउंडेशन, though it is through different ways how you are making it possible, either it is formal or informal, but you are making it possible only when you give a chance to the student to be get into the educational system in the early ages of
government of India ne bilkul Ena Sharma sahab iska naam bhi jo hai na wo rakha hai early childhood care
and education,
ha care and education, ECCE,
right?
तो मतलब अब इसमें क्या है कि
ECCE,
हाँ जी ECCE, अब उसमें एक तरफ तो ये कह रहे हैं कि जैसे आप ही ने पढ़ाया हुआ है कि शायद 80% से ज्यादा ब्रेन डेवलपमेंट जो है वो 6 साल से पहले हो जाती है, और हमारे देश में ना ये बड़ी इंपॉर्टेंट चीज है, किसानों के बच्चे, सोल्जर्स के बच्चे, अभी पेरेंट्स क्या प्रेफर करते हैं, मैं बच्चों के साथ कॉलेज मायर कॉलेज के बच्चों को बताना चाहूंगा, पेरेंट्स जो हैं मिडिल क्लास फैमिलीज इंडिया में, उनके लिए बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज होगा, दे वांट बच्चे की कॉपी में रिटन वर्क हो, बच्चे ने स्कूल में लिखित काम किया हो, घर में कॉपी में कुछ आए, और जो स्कूल्स होमवर्क नहीं करते दे आर नॉट कंसिडर्ड गुड स्कूल्स बाय दी by a section of Indian population. अभी कुछ parents इस चीज में pride feel लेते हैं कि यार हमारा बच्चा तो कोई homework नहीं है, वो तो school जाता है, खेलता है, और वहाँ पे वो art, craft, singing, dance. But larger population in the country sees good education is one in which there is classwork, homework, written work. तो इस चैलेंज ये भी एक चैलेंज रहेगा कि आप ठीक बोल रहे थे कि सोसाइटी में आप कैसे ये परिवर्तन लाएंगे इसको एक्सेप्ट करने का.
राइट. सो एनी अदर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम टीचर्स और स्टूडेंट्स?
नो सर, देयर इज नो क्वेश्चन इन द चैट बॉक्स.
राइट.
एनीबडी वांट्स टू आस्क एनी क्वेश्चन स्टूडेंट्स?
दैट्स Yeah,
with the permission of the chair, since I am a part of this panel, but I do find so learned speakers over here. So one question is coming up in my mind, that when we talk for this national education policy, and there is a paradigm shift, there is going to be a paradigm shift, but my question to everyone here is, like, are we ready for it or not? What is our preparedness towards it? When we talk for integrated, or when we are talking for inclusion, or when we are talking for, you know, patterns or other things, and when there is an amalgamation of subjects, so our institutions are being teachers, we are ready for it? This is just a question in my mind, because we can't just be we can't start it simply. Right. Yes, this is a policy and we have to implement, but what is our preparedness for it?
Sharma sir,
actually kya hai Dr. Ronika, preparedness NCERT is awfully busy with the preparation of a curriculum for different classes,
huh? Yes,
and they started even before the approval of the this report. So they were assigned this task that, okay, you go ahead and this will be done. And I think from the next year, if everything goes well, when I say goes well, this COVID problem must be over and there should be regular schooling.
Sure.
Parents and students should be ready to come to the school. And I hope it will be from the next session.
Okay.
If everything goes well.
Finger crossed, sir.
Oh, it is always there. It is always there.
Yes.
Because it depends upon n number of factors, the human factor and the other extraneous variables,
right,
and the interfering variables.
True, sir. Thank you.
The thing is that irrespective of what we think of this policy is here to stay, and we have to prepare ourselves. We have to gear up. We have to, you know, adopt to new norms and standards that would be initiated and established. So. Only time will tell whether the steps that we take now would be fruitful and helpful, and that is how, you know, things are. And we are hopeful that this would be more job oriented, more skill oriented, and students right out of college would be able to find the job of their choice. So with that, I think so we can conclude the session, and Komal ma'am, you can have the vote of thanks, and then we can call it a day.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Now I request Mrs. Ruchika Sharma, co-curricular committee, to kindly present a formal vote of thanks.
Thank you, Komal ma'am. A very good afternoon to one and all present here. I, Ruchika Sharma, deem it my proud privilege to propose formal vote of thanks on behalf of co-curricular committee, Meyer College of Education. First and foremost, I thank to our worthy principal and director, Dr. Adit Gupta. His guidance has always encouraged us. I thank him for his continued support. I am indeed grateful to Professor N.R. Sharma, Dean Academics, for sparing time from his valuable schedule to be with us at this occasion. I am extremely thankful to Dr. Vikram Gulati, Principal Shivalik College of Education. Sir, your presence today in this event has immensely enhanced its importance. I would like to extend my sincere thanks to Dr. Moolraj Sharma, HOD PG Department, Meyer College of Education. I am happy to express my thanks to Dr. Ronika Sharma, HOD, UG department, and all the faculty members from Meyer College of Education for gracing the occasion. I also thank all the concerned who participated in the organization of this event, directly or indirectly. Thank you all the panelists for joining us in such a short time. Thank you all. Have a nice day. Thank you so much.
So thank you very much. There is just one last question that I just saw right now. So yes. One of our young budding students has asked, what was the need of this policy? So I would just like to try to reply to you in a very short, answer that, you know, the previous policy was in place for 33 years. And 33 years is a huge time to see some changes in the society, some changes in the system of education and how transaction of education is taking place in classrooms and in colleges and universities. And with the advancement in technology, in the advancement in education, with more focus on research, there were a lot of gap areas in the previous policies, which probably people in their 60s and 70s could not have imagined that when the society will transform and education will take a new shape. So these changes will take place. But now we have seen, a change that is happening everywhere. We are becoming more global. Everything is becoming more international. With the influx of internet and technology, things are rapidly coming into our society and changing how we work, think, find solution to the problem. So there was a need to develop some new level skills in both teachers and students. There was a need to change the curriculum because, you know, earlier 5-5, 6-6 saal B.Ed ka curriculum 10 saal tak kabhi change hi nahi hota tha. Ab har 2 saal mein, 3 saal mein change karne ki zarurat padti hai because nayi cheeze aa rahi hai, nayi cheeze sikhane ki zarurat pad rahi hai. Aaj agar hum jaise sab panelists ne kaha ki technology ko hame sabko adopt karna pada COVID ke duran. Isse pehle hum technology kehte the sabko seekh lo, par everybody used to take it so lightly. But aaj, if somebody who does not know how to utilize these various tools of technology, they would not be successful. So when things change, when there is a shift in the thinking, when there is a change in, you know, the way we do things, hence our policy should also align with the way we plan to work or we intend to work in future. So aaj, कॉलेजेस को अक्रेडिटेशन लेनी है या उनको अगर स्टार्ट करना है तो यूनिवर्सिटी 4-4, 5-5 साल तो सिर्फ इंस्पेक्शनों में और उसमें ही लगा देती है. तो कॉलेज कब कोर्स शुरू करेगा, कब पढ़ाई कराएगा बच्चों को, और तभी बच्चे जो हैं वो एनरोलमेंट रेशियो कंट्री में हमारी बहुत कम है. सो अब सब ऑटोनोमस कॉलेज बनेंगे, सब अपने प्रोग्राम्स रन कर सकेंगे, एग्जामिनेशंस टाइम पे होंगे, किसी पे डिपेंड नहीं करना पड़ेगा रिजल्ट के लिए. सो अगर हम इसको ब्रॉड सेंस में सोचें तो बहुत बड़ा चेंज जो है वो हमारे एजुकेशन सिस्टम में आने वाला है. सो दैट इज व्हाई देयर वाज अ नीड ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग अ न्यू पॉलिसी एंड टू ब्रिंग इंडिया टू द लेवल वेयर वी कैन कम्पीट ग्लोबली. सो देयर वाज अ रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग अ न्यू एजुकेशनल पॉलिसी इन आवर कंट्री. आई होप आई वॉज एबल टू आंसर सम आस्पेक्ट ऑफ योर क्वेश्चन, बट thank you very much for asking a very pertinent question, and I would like to thank all the participants and panelists on behalf of the Meyer College of Education for participating in this panel discussion, and hope and believe that we'll have many such chances in futures to interact and provide a good meaningful interaction for our students as well. So thank you very much all of you for joining us today in celebrating this National Education Day.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Sir, it's with your support and guidance that we could organize such a panel discussion. Adit, sir.